In education also, there are four multimedia tools which have been invented recently, four multimedia tools. You know that education is full of phobia, I have already told. Chemistry means lot of equations, that is chemophobia. Physics means lot of derivation, that is physiophobia. Biology means lot of parts and we have to denote the inner parts of all of these things, and evolution is to be studied, that is biophobia. And mathematics, there are lot of expressions and arithmetic progressions, that is arithmophobia. And English is giving a problem, that is anglophobia. Any language is giving a problem, that is lingophobia. Teacher is giving a problem, that is acrophobia. And books are giving problems, bibliophobia. So everywhere we are giving and getting problems. And to eradicate the phobia, to create attraction towards education, four major tools have been developed. One is for learning mathematics. Second is for understanding algebra. And the third thing is for understanding foreign languages, how to adapt the foreign languages, the structure, shape, style, slang, source, output, vocabulary, fluency, torrential flow, adaptability, then content richness. Everything should be manipulated by a person with a foreign language. A person who is very much socialized with a structuralized language of the innate, independent, inhabited environment, to adopt a new language is very difficult. So that is there. Then how to learn music and other arts through these things, now they are making. If anybody can make a program, after completing this 6 months or 1 year, they are going to jump into some job. So that should be some dedicated person who is not job oriented, but joy oriented and success oriented, commitment and service oriented in the society. At least 10 people, they have to think and work out with softwares and multimedia tools, how to make music successful, how to make administration successful. There are four problems. Music and art forms, they are having a complex structure. Mathematics and algebra, complex structure. Foreign languages having a complex structure. Their understanding of science and scientific concepts, that type of complexity and intricacy, understanding the sequential, source study, consequential and compatibility study is very difficult. For understanding these four things, they are preparing a lot of software. If the softwares are designed, you will be a trillionaire. If you are going to manufacture, you will be a billionaire. At least if you are going to sell them, you will be at least a millionaire. So somebody should concentrate developing educational tools on that. More than on entertainment, you are having at least 10 million of jobs for Indians alone after 10 years if this type of education methodology is going to develop. Then the communication, I already told about video, text and other things which have failed because of non-adoption by the proper society. They have not been taught at all. They are going for only crazy products. Whether they have earning, whether they have the rice for the dinner or not, they will be having a SIM card on mobile. I don't know what they use, whether they are having work or not, they are having that. So this type of lack of opportunity, lack of utility, driven by just a craze. It is known as craze manufacturing. Westerners, they have clearly understood that we are crazy people. That's why they are manufacturing their products and giving to us. And we are thinking that we are developing without understanding that somebody is developing by exploiting us. We are not understanding that thing at all. Then knowledge management, it is known as MMKM, multimedia knowledge management, which is an emerging industry. For example, in knowledge synthesis, we are having informative database, informative data processing, data access, anytime access, multiple access, interactive access. We are having innumerable things like Wikipedia, like Wiki Dictionary, Wikiversity we are having, and also virtual video, video on demand, video out of necessity, self video making, self video clipping, broad space, infinite space, inestimable space. These things are given by things like YouTube. Now we can have everything. The space is more and CPU time has been made scalable. Now have you heard of Amazon Cloud? We are having Amazon Cloud, we are having YouTube, we are having Wikipedia, innumerable sources of data preservation, sound transfer, video transfer, and multiple sources are there emerging. Multiple sources of emerging means three things are there. One, things will become cheaper. More people will get opportunities. Third thing, access will be unlimited. Getting that knowledge, you can get new dimensions. Somebody told, if everything is open, then it will free of cost. If everything is open, then open access will create free of cost. Then how we can earn? But God has created such a design that we can get knowledge for earning from free sources. From getting the knowledge from free sources, that knowledge is free. That knowledge is free. See, the same air is free. If you want to get the same air through a pump in a cycle station, then you have to pay 25 paise. Likewise, give the same open source knowledge, like we are having digital open access library. Digital open access library. It is known as a DOJ, digital open access journals. Digital open access of journals. All journals are published there. Based on that particular right, if you make something innovative, if you get some incentive from that free sources and develop something useful for the society, for that you will be paid and you can pay. So open source not only creates things at cheaper of cost and free of cost, that also provides you good employment and earning facilities. A person understanding something freely available as useless is an idiot. It is lunatic to think that free sources are not of any use. Free sources give you free knowledge. That free knowledge makes you to process the knowledge and apply the same thing in practical field so that you can earn, gain more knowledge and also more compatibility with earning with growing system. That is also possible. Now content management, multimedia content management is there. It is very essential, multimedia content management, but that requires some intellect. You can draw something, paint something, that is different. Content management, you should have some stuff inside. That stuff cannot be created from the machine. All the other managements are supported by the software. Content management, you have to support through the software. That is the difference between content management and other management. So this has created a lot of other opportunities. You might have heard about Adopt-It, the Adopt-It system. Whereby they have created five major schools of thought. Five major schools of thought with five special mega processes in five major industries. Number one, it is known as EDICT, E-D-I-C-T. It is a system which is meant for unifying the TV flow of multivarious components that are there in TV flow. In a TV flow relay with multi-node door access, we will be having multi-pattern designs going through different channels. They all can be unified in a single TV flow. All these components can be encapsulated in a single flow, unified flow. That is why it is known as EDICT, E-D-I-C-T. That goes like that. And Weddell Music, recently they have introduced a second system known as Weddell Music, W-E-D-E-L, Weddell Music, wherein by you can imagine music with that. It is also having imagination. If you say the person, then it also imagines two swaras. It gives you the opportunity to think with the various permutations and alterations. If the guy is not Komal or Divra, how it will be? If it is Gappasa instead of that Pasaga, how it will be? So it leads you with imagination. That which imagines, leads your imagination, boosts your imagination, softs your imagination, composes your imagination as a compositor, that can make you to analyze music, learn music, enjoy music and distribute music, that has been now formed as Weddell Music System. Likewise, now we are having KISWOM, KISWOM system, C-A-S-W-O-M, KISWOM. This KISWOM system is dealing with archiving all of your audiovisual concepts. To preserve all of the audiovisual concepts, so whenever you want to have comparative study, whenever you have having to have any futuristic study or sequential analytical study, it will help you. The fourth thing is CULTOS, C-U-L-T-O-S. This CULTOS system, these things are in the crude stage. If there is any designer from our side, from Arena Multimedia, who can process and make it more successful, it will be a crown or it will be an added jewel to the technical industry or multimedia industry of our land. This is at just in the crude level. CULTOS deals with synchronization, conceptualization, developing, processing, orderly placement, analytical study, sequential study and processing study of concept development in data processing as well as in script management. It is very much useful in this area. That is known as CULTOS. And there is now newly advanced system of Busman has been introduced. B-U-S-M-A-N, Busman. What is the process of Busman? It can process, it can secure and govern thousands of nodes of larger digital video database. Now, database itself is very strong. You know that video database that acquires more space than sound database. In that the digital video database that acquires because of its more clarity and depth, it acquires more space. In that if it is multi-nodular, it is having more space. So infinite space, I have already told, inescapable, inestimable source is occupied by these things. And they have to be processed through heterogeneous channels, innumerable channels. So multinodular digital video database processed through heterogeneous channels. It can be very effectively governed in a fraction of a second by this Busman with security and with processing efficiency. So these five systems are crude. If somebody wants independently to think, let them go.